Adam.
Yeah.
Do you like to agree with me?
I really do.
You're such an agreeable guy, but not today.
You're right. I'm Adam Maness.
And I'm Peter Martin.
You're listening to the You'll Hear Podcast.
Daily jazz advice coming at you. Hump day, right?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Did I throw that out too soon?
No, that's correct.
Why you look so...
Because you've never once been right.
Well, now somebody wrote it for me, so I know.
We did this on purpose. We have a Hump Day special. Stay tuned. Or should we say it now?
Let's say it then.
We have a Hump Day special, and I did this because I know how much you love offers and that you would definitely remember this. It's like I heard this trick about learning someone new's name, and I thought this was really good advice. If you are meeting someone new, and let's say we're meeting each other here for the first time.
Hi, Adam.
Hi, what's your name?
Peter.
Peter, can you pass me those headphones, please?
Yes. Here you go, Adam.
So request something by using someone's name, and you'll remember it faster because our brains are like, I need something from that person.
Let's see if this works. What's my name?
Peter.
I thought you were going to call me headphones.
I mean, I've known you for like years and years, but okay.
Yeah. Request something. But that could be kind of random, right?
Yeah.
Like you just meet someone. Oh, could you hand me that?
Yeah.
You could rob them at the same time.
No, but that's like, hey, Joe, could you hand me that napkin? Now I know that guy's name's Joe.
No, it's Peter. I'm Peter, not
okay,
Joe.
Okay. Well,
that was close.
This failed miserably. Okay, but no, this was the idea with Peter's Hump Day special.
Yeah.
Is that what it is?
Peter's Hump? Yeah, now you're calling it the right thing. That's what it says here. Peter's Hump Day special. We're not going to say it till the end.
If we did an offer, because Peter likes an offer, then he'll remember that Hump Day is on Wednesday.
Well, we should have called it Peter's Wednesday Hump Day special then. But that's okay. Yeah. We got it. Happy Wednesday, man. Happy Hump Day.
Happy Hump Day.
Good. What are we talking about today?
Well, you know, we are agreeable folks just by nature. And right.
Agreeable to a fault, as Key and Peele say.
We're usually on the same page with stuff. And this is why we have this podcast, because we could talk at each other for forever on similar things. So we thought we'd kind of list seven things we don't agree on.
That's right.
I thought there would be a lot more than seven, but turns
there
out...
There were.
Yeah.
Remember, we had to filter out.
I disagree.
See, remember when I came in today, I said, I want to do seven things we don't agree on. And you were like, yeah, cool. You were immediately like you had a catalog of 100. I've been waiting to get these out, you know? So that was kind of fun. And then we asked Dan, we're like, can you think of anything that we don't agree? He's like,
definitely. Tons.
So maybe we're not as agreeable as we think.
Maybe not.
Well, we'll find out today.
We'll find out. Okay.
Should we start?
All right. Yeah.
What's number one?
Number one is carbohydrates slash meat.
I think we don't agree on carbs. They're essential for living.
Yeah.
But yeah, I seem to like to eat more than you do on a daily basis, right?
What, carbs?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't.
Because you go total anti-carb sometimes.
I have been since October. Yeah.
Yeah, and I don't. I'm all about the. I'm not only about the carbs.
Yeah. No, I'm not only about the meat, but I eat a lot of meat, and you are not so much about the meat.
I'm not eating meat. Hashtag plant-based. Yeah. Plant-based lifestyle.
How long have you been on the plant-based lifestyle?
Since December 30th of last year. Since the beginning of the
year.
That's
really great, man.
Chicago. I had December 30th. I had a hamburger.
Nice.
Very good hamburger.
Yeah, that's great.
Actually, I've had burgers since then, but they're like Beyond Burgers, Impossible Burgers.
I hear the Impossible Burger is really good, actually.
Impossible Burger is good. It's not super healthy, but it's good.
Tastes
like a burger.
So we thought about this, number one, because when we go out, sometimes we'll go out with our friend Sean, and he'll notice that we, we'll order a dish, and it's like, I can't eat the bread that it's based on, and you can't eat the meat that's on top. And so,
we're not agreeing on those things.
We'll pick apart,
And it's not like we can't. Not like we're allergic to them.
No. It's just we prefer not to.
It's a lifestyle that we don't agree on.
It's interesting, though, isn't it?
We could do a whole show about vegan versus keto, because I think I'd win that one. I'm just putting it out there.
You do like to put your vegan lifestyle on a moral
pedestal.
And I'd push...
No, I'm not even talking about moral.
About that a little
I'm not
bit,
even
but
talking.
I'm not,
that's
I'm not
good.
Here
now look,
to,
we're arguing.
No,
see?
It's good. I mean, this is we're why we don't agree on it. But
no, but I'm not even saying morally. I'm saying from a health standpoint. If we were to put that, get us in the comments below. Let us know what you
there,
think.
There
about.
Is science that I think would surprise you.
Really?
Yeah.
Is it by licensed scientists?
No. It's just that being a vegan doesn't necessarily mean that you have a healthy lifestyle.
No, but being a keto does not mean you have a healthy lifestyle.
No, but it doesn't necessarily mean you don't have a healthy lifestyle either.
As does vegan.
Exactly right. So it's about how you do it.
Now we're agreeing.
I mean, a lot of people say they play, the piano, but that doesn't mean everybody plays the piano well.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Exactly. You happen to play the piano very well. I would assume that you're vegan, but you're also trying to be as healthy as you can with it, as am I. I mean, you see what I eat most lunches, like a bowl of greens with some chicken on it.
So you'll see me out for a drink eating a big thing of French fries, which is what we call a junk food vegan.
Yeah, totally.
Which is not very healthy. Yeah. So maybe I'm not the best one for this. Let's move on. How about that? That was only number one of the things we don't agree on.
Some of these are going to go by pretty fast.
Yeah. I mean,
like,
what are we gonna...
like the next one, socks.
Yeah, we don't agree on socks because, but to me, this is silly. Look, you can see now.
Summertime, I'm no socks. I mean, yeah. I do have hidden socks on, but.
Yeah, so is this like a, this is not an agreement, a disagreement on socks, yay or nay. It's the type of sock.
Sometimes, you know, I do.
You've got the little girly invisible ones. Sorry.
No, I do like the invisible sock. I also, but you know what? When I do my nice leather loafers, I'll go no socks.
When have you ever done nice leather loafers? We're going negative today.
Just
I love
yesterday,
it.
Yesterday, man. Those are those.
No,
are my...
no, you had those old beat up brown loafers.
Buddy, those are my Alden. Those are classics. You can't get past those, man.
Penny
but
loafers.
Yeah, I will go. I'll go no socks, and that's something that I don't think you would do.
You
confidently.
Go sans socks. I mean, I'll go no socks at the beach.
Yeah.
That's a no sock zone for me.
Yeah.
Perhaps on a float trip, I might go no socks.
I'm just astonished at how long we've gotten out of this socks bit.
I know.
It's a lot.
Too long.
I mean, all right.
I can tell you one thing. Our audience is not with us anymore. Yeah, they just dropped off.
If right you're there. Still listening, I'm impressed with how long you've stayed with this socks bit.
All right, let's talk about some music. Some
okay,
things.
Good.
This was actually hard for us to come up with some stuff.
Yeah, we were thinking about artists that maybe we disagreed about.
No, because what are we going to be like? Brad Melda. No, I like him. He's good.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
Not like as much as you, but okay. No, but we were able to find something that's more of like a conceptual, not a conceptual. It's like a. Well, why don't you tell it? Because I really don't understand it.
Drop two.
Yeah. So we don't agree on that. But this is from no. It's not like a for and against. I don't really understand it.
You do though.
But do I play it?
You do sometimes.
So then I'm not against it.
You
right?
just don't. You just haven't like. You just haven't.
It's a mental block for me.
Strategized it. You haven't like mapped it out of like how you want to do it. But you do it all the time. You just don't know you do it. You
but
do
I
it more
like...
in the context of tenths.
Okay.
And then you'll fill in the chord. And a lot of time that's drop two. Whereas I've actually like kind of worked out a little drop two system.
You know what
that
it
I
is?
Like to practice.
You know what it is? I don't agree with you on. I don't like giving things names like that.
You don't. That's so true.
I don't like because it makes it feel like oh a seal drop two. I was like no this is my thing. Although it isn't my thing. Of course we're all stealing. Stuff but I hate it when it just gets to be like you know like it's a motor oil style or whatever.
I know. Well, you know, this is what I'm not going to agree on a lot of people with about things like the viral like Barry Harris videos or whatever.
Yeah.
People love him because he's so dogmatic in him.
Yeah.
But I my feathers get a little ruffled about that because I feel like while what he's teaching is brilliant, like there's no one right way to do anything.
Well, I like
you know?
This. Okay, let's make that the next one. Barry Harris, somebody we don't agree on. I love Barry Harris.
I love
you.
Barry Harris too.
We don't agree on him, see?
We don't agree on my stance on Barry Harris. I'll tell you
yeah,
how it.
Yeah.
All right, number four.
Okay, number four, cars.
Oh, yeah.
We don't agree on cars. You might think, oh, is he a Buick guy and you're a Nissan guy? No, it's not that. I'm an electric guy.
Yeah.
You're an ice guy.
Yeah.
So I love the environment. You hate the environment. That's
oh
how that goes.
Gosh, look at this. I'm just eating meat and driving like a Ford Mustang over here.
No, we probably are many cars that we do agree on, but I have had an electric car now, electric cars for like almost 5 years. I'm kind of an early adopter and they have their limitations. I don't know if you know a little thing called range anxiety. I'm getting nervous even saying it.
Yeah.
Which can be, it's a real thing.
Yeah,
and,
for sure.
And one time in 5 years of electric car ownership, I ran out of battery. One time.
Yeah.
Tow came. Big shout out to Nissan, free tow. But you're more of an ice guy, though.
You know, I would love an electric car. It's just I haven't bought a new car in the time that they've been out.
Dude, man, you can get some great deals on electric cars.
Right no, you now. Know what I have? I have.
You just need a long extension cord.
I have an awesome little, like, fuel-efficient Honda with a manual transmission. I love that thing, man.
Yeah.
I'm driving that in the ground. I'm giving that to my daughter, and then I'm getting an electric car.
Nice. Good yeah. good stuff. Oh, yeah. Damn. Then we have to take it off our agreeable list.
I like this next one, though.
Oh, this is so inside
number
St.
five.
Louis.
Yeah.
Okay, if you are not from St. Louis, and if you don't live in St. Louis or don't know a little bit about the history of St. Louis, you won't understand this, but we're going to explain a little bit. But you might want to Google the Delmar Divide. This is actually a very serious subject.
It's really something. I actually was commissioned to write a piece of music about the Delmar Divide.
That's
once.
Right. Yeah. I mean, this is like a serious cultural phenomenon in St. Louis that also was replayed in many Midwestern cities and Southern. I mean, Southern is a little different, but all across the country, and it was sort of typified here. But this is which of Delmar? Oh, which side of Delmar to live on?
That's
we
right.
don't agree on that. Delmar is like the main east-west kind of original thoroughfare. It's just a street.
It separates north-south in the city
yes.
of St. Louis.
And I've always been a kind of north of Delmar guy. I've always lived north of Delmar, and you've always been a south of Delmar
This really
guy.
Could be you know, U City versus not U City. Let's be honest here. Because U City folks, you are from U City.
Yeah. University City we're talking about.
You folks are passionate about U City, and you always kind of stick around U City.
We do.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it is kind of, but what's interesting, the actual Delmar divide is really not about U City. It's about
St. Louis.
Because it kind of ends, I mean, the divide in, you know, always historically in University City was Olive.
Yeah.
You know, that was always north or south of Olive. But I mean, in general, there's also the kind of north versus south, not versus. But
no, that's definitely a thing of like South City versus North City or whatever. I mean, I'm from like, you know, Jefferson County. So I'm from
South. Is that even called South County? Would that be considered?
No. It's too way far south west. Of South County. Oh, that's south. Where I grew up. But now I live in South City and it still feels too far north to me.
Yeah. But South City's, and the great thing about St. Louis, I mean, for all its faults, and St. Louis people are great at putting the city down and whatever, and we've had some very negative things about, you know, in the national press that are true.
Yeah.
But they're also things that other cities grapple with. But South St. Louis is not the same as when I was coming up. North St. Louis is not the same. I mean, where I live is actually central.
Yep.
What they call it, they didn't even call it when I was a kid, mid-corridor or whatever, mid. So, I mean, you know, St. Louis is it's still way too segregated in a lot of ways, but there's been a lot of, you know, cultural interspersion in different areas, and not every area is just like typically what you think it is from when we were growing up, which is great.
I mean, then there's all those people who live west of 170, which I don't know what
those are
doing.
Not humans.
Yeah, I don't know what those they're are doing not up humans. There. Okay, this one is
big shout out to Town and Country. Where you at?
The next one, what is this? Number six? Yeah, number six.
Oh, this is topical.
This is funny because we actually like the same drink. Like the cocktail is the same.
Right.
We like a nice Manhattan.
A nice Manhattan.
But we
I'll take Manhattan, so will Adam.
That's how agreeable we are on stuff, but
then it breaks down.
It breaks down. Like last night, I was like up,
and I said
rocks.
Yeah. The first part of the question: what would you like, sir?
Can we still be friends?
Yeah, that's the good. It's the follow up that we start to disagree. Oh, Manhattan, up or on the rocks?
Yeah. All right. Now, number seven is relevant to today's episode,
and that is number seven already. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. Number seven.
Number seven is what day is Hump Day?
Okay. That, you know what? It's not always the same. That's
it
my
is
thing.
The same.
No, I'll agree this week it's Wednesday because it's today. But remember that a couple weeks ago when I was like, it was a Friday and I was like, Hump Day.
Yeah, you don't get to call it Hump Day.
Why not? Day. Man, dude, I'm a jazz musician. Oh, I'm flexible.
We're definitely going to keep disagreeing on this. Okay, it is Hump Day.
Yeah, it is Hump Day.
So let's do our Hump Day special.
Wait, are we there yet?
Yeah.
Oh, but we got the bonus.
Oh, we got a bonus. So stick around for the bonus.
So we'll do that after. Because that's kind of, that was a funny one from Dan, right?
Yeah, it was.
Unlike these other ones.
Yeah. We talked about socks for 2.5 minutes.
Yeah. Okay, so the Hump Day special, which is today. Actually, this is Peter's Hump Day special. Let's say it right. We don't even agree on the name of it.
It's got to stick
in mind. But we're going to do this for as long as we want. So it might just be today. No, we're going to try to do this every Wednesday to keep me on track.
Word.
Understanding what Hump Day is.
Okay.
And it's a little special something. We like doing something special. They've been popular in the past, specifically for our You'll Hear It listeners. We're sponsored by Open Studio.
Yep.
So we're going to give some stuff away, maybe some swag at some point. But today, we're going to bring back for just until the next episode drops. So just until tonight at 3 a.m. Is that correct? Central time. Yeah. So you got to get on this. So this is a today only kind of thing. You'll Hear It Premium. Tell them a little bit about You'll Hear It Premium so folks that don't know.
You'll Hear It Premium is a way that you can support You'll Hear It, and you can also access the full archive, hundreds of episodes.
Right.
And then we do premium episodes.
Yep.
Every month. And those come with things like PDF resources. They're basically like little lessons.
At the piano. Yeah,
you get access to the Facebook group. You get discount off You'll Hear It swag. And it's just a way you could support and get some nice features in return every month.
Yeah. So that's You'll Hear a Premium. So this is just today only 50% off that.
Yeah.
So it will be off the yearly or the monthly.
That's
it's
right.
already really cheap. You'll see on
that's
there.
Right. That's
but
right.
But use coupon code HumpDay1.
Hump Day 1. Yeah.
So $5 a month, you can get it on You'll Hear a Premium. And then, or $45 a year, that's even better. And then you can keep that for as long as you want. And discount on swag.
Nah.
No, they don't.
I'm just disagreeing.
Oh, you're disagreeing.
No.
Okay.
No, there all is. Right. There is a discount.
So yeah, Hump Day 1. Expires tonight at 3 a.m.
Can we put a link there, Andrew, too, for the folks?
We got a link there.
Good, good, good.
And then, so the thing with this, we've got a bonus now, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Two bonuses.
Yeah.
We're going to give them two bonuses.
Two bonuses.
These are seven. This is number 8 and number 9 of things we don't agree on.
Mm-hmm.
There's not going to be a lot of explanation. The first one is height.
Mm-hmm.
We don't agree on the perfect size human. I would say that's 5'6". What would you say?
I'd say about 6'1".
Yeah, see, we don't agree on that. Yeah. And then the second one is use of shampoo. I do not use it. And do you?
Yeah.
Total disagreement. So until tomorrow.
You'll hear it.